realizes your obedience is required.
Oh.
If you want this relationship.
Don't pay any attention to that. None.
All right, because you do what you want to do.
Don't.
I got a line, girls. A mile long outside. Waiting for me to go.
That's okay, because right. I'm sure there's plenty of Magnesites out there that wouldn't mind taking your place.
Hold on now, Magnesites. You're putting yourself in a dangerous area. If you're going to mess with the snow leopard. Yeah. Anyway, I'm back and I have returned. Black Kryptonian, the Black Tiger. Lord Magnus has descended from his throne.
Do you see the bullshit I have to put up with every day?
Check this one out. I like this one. It says, hey Tyrone, you made a video for me a couple months ago for why I couldn't get girls attracted to me, and I said I would keep you updated on how things are going. Everything is going very smooth now. My grades in school are at an all-time high.
See what happens when you listen?
Yeah, you should pay more attention to this because you need to listen more, yeah.
Holy shit.
Life would be a whole lot better if she was more obedient.
Have to obey. And I don't.
We're moving, matter of fact, we're gonna move to the Middle East. Where women are more obedient. Have a whole
The chances of him getting me to move to the Middle East to put on a burqa are about this big.
And you will walk 3 feet behind me, as you're supposed to. Anyway,
I'm about to push you right out of the camera.
Alright, so I took your advice. Let me see. He says, grades are at all-time high. Everything is going very smooth now. My grades are at all-time high. I have a lot of friends that are girls, and I've never been so confident. I took your advice and haven't asked any girls out at all, and I'm loving life for the first time.
Good.
But now I have a question for you and Sarah that's been bugging me lately. I don't consider this a problem, but I do want to understand this or want to know if it is all in my head. So every time I approach a girl, that's right, I approach girls now not giving a fuck if I get their number, not because I know it's their loss if I don't. Yeah, that's right, buddy. He's learning.
Just read it.
They always say they have a boyfriend, and I say I'm not looking to date them. Just meet someone new, nothing more. So they always say they're in a relationship and they treat me like only a friend, which I don't mind at all. But they are like this until they see my car.
Mm-mm.
An 06 Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution. Evolution. That's
read
what I'm looking to get.
Email.
Shut up, Steph. Or find out how much I make. I make $20 an hour. Then all of a sudden, the girl starts trying to flirt with me a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on.
See, your phone.
The phone went blank.
Phone knew he took too long to read it.
Yeah, it says, want to flirt with me a lot. Have asked me out shortly after. I even counted how many.
What?
16.
That's crazy.
No, I'm not the kind of guy to brag or show off because I know what it's like to come from a family that doesn't have much, but I do take a lot of pride in what I have earned. Each time I said I'm not interested though, because I don't want to be with anyone right now. Just want to focus on myself and keep improving my confidence. I even had my best friend watch this happen and even listen to it on the phone and read the text, so I know it's not all in my head. So I want to know, why does this keep happening? Once again, can you have Sarah in this video? What she had to say last time was extremely helpful as well. One more thing, I finally lost my virginity.
Yay!
And really have you and Sarah to thank.
Well, you're welcome. Not that that's our goal,
but... I don't know if your parents would be happy with that, but,
I'm sure that boosted your confidence.
So, Sarah, I would have wanted you in this video, too. Why, after finding out what type of car he drives and the money he makes at that
age. Unfortunately, there's a lot of gold diggers out there. Mm-hmm. I have never told a guy I have a boyfriend and then found out how much he made or saw his car, and then all of a sudden my boyfriend disappeared. I mean, how do these girls even explain that? Oh, we broke up yesterday, the day after I found out what kind of car you had. Like, what kind of trifling crap is that? I don't know. It seems like you're running into a lot of gold diggers, apparently. But you know what? You're good. You're right for saying, I just want to focus on me right now and not getting with them. Because is that really the kind of girl you want to get with in the first place? So, right. You know, what you want to be looking for is, you know, they accept you for who you are before they find all that out. And then it's just a bonus once they say, oh, you got a nice car or whatever, you know? So, I don't know. It sounds like you're running into a lot of gold diggers, unfortunately. But maybe the universe knows that you need to focus on yourself right now. And you don't need to be dating anybody. So, just let this build your confidence. You're pulling them in, obviously. 16 people interested in you. But not the right kind of people interested in it.
16 girls first acted like no.
That's a lot.
That's a lot of fucking... And that's another thing. And you know what? I'm not even going to jump on you, but I'm not coming down on you. This is making me wonder how you physically carry yourself. Because they're not interested right away. But as soon as they see the car,
now
they realize how you're financially set. I don't know, do you carry yourself kind of frumpy or whatever? But it doesn't matter. You see what I'm saying? It doesn't matter because, first of all, you're not a virgin anymore. You're still attracting girls. But these other things, like your ambition, the money you're making, and don't take it negatively, but a lot of times girls see that as stability. They see it as ambition. They see it as a motivated man. Like, look, he's got a nice car. He's got a good job.
I don't have to take
he's
care of him. He can help take care of me.
Right. He's a good husband material. A lot of girls are trained. They literally are raised to look for that. Make sure he's got a nice car and he's got a good job. As soon as they found that out, all of a sudden, they wanted you.
I dated a guy once. One time I dated him. And he had a Corvette. And he had lots of money. His parents had money. And I didn't know any of this when I went on that first date with him. And then once he showed me, he was talking about his car, he was talking about the money he had. And then later, when we were talking on the phone, it was like, well, I don't understand why girls are always interested in my car and my money. Well, that's what you're presenting yourself with. Not that you're doing that.
He flaunted it
and couldn't figure out why he kept getting the same kind of girl. So in your case, I'm not entirely sure. I mean, it could be like what Tyrone was saying. Maybe you're not,
you don't carry yourself real pretty.
Physically
and
exuding.
Yeah.
Attractiveness, I don't know, but,
like, if you're just, like, one of those dudes that's a regular dude, you step out in your jeans and t-shirt, you don't have any flashy jewelry, extra gel in your hair, any of that shit, that's fine. But a lot of times, girls are initially attracted to that look. A lot of times, they'll find out, a lot of guys like that are an asshole.
Thank you.
Don't ever touch me again.
I'm like, do you see him hanging out with the camera over here?
Don't ever touch me.
Shut up, babe.
But what I'm saying is sometimes they're attracted to that look, but without the substance of the guy. But I'm just trying to figure you out, man. Like, that's really interesting that many...
Do we know how old he is?
That many that you just approach to say hello, and...
They're like, I got a man. It could be
your
age.
As soon as I get in my car, now all of a sudden you want to be my friend? Fuck you.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? I don't like that they're doing that.
If he's like 17 or 18, though, then that's kind of what girls that age are looking at.
Yeah.
Because it makes them feel older and more attractive when they got a guy who's got money in that awkward age.
You know what I mean? You're growing into your body. I'm going to show y'all some pictures of me when I was a teen.
You want to see
one of these days.
Both of us were bad, and not in a good way.
I mean,
not in a Michael Jackson bad kind of way. We were just horrible.
Yeah. Very awkward looking teens. And if you are in that stage, then I would understand why they might be like, nah, you know, whatever. But as soon as they see your money, then they're like,
You need to call them on their shit. Because if they said, I got a boyfriend, and then a few days later they're asking you out, you need to be like, well, what happened to your boyfriend? Because you told me you had a boyfriend, and maybe you can start getting some answers there.
Yeah.
Make them be honest with you.
Yeah. Call them on their shit. Put them up front. Like, listen, I appreciate you calling me and all of everything, and now you want to go out, but I don't understand why before you had a man, and now you don't. Because this has happened 15 other times with girls. Say to them, be up front with me. Is it my look? Do you not like my look? What is it? Like, because I don't get it. So, and that's good, man. Your grades are all at all-time high. You're doing your thing. You're progressing as a man. I ain't got no problems with you. Have my hats off to you. Doing way better than me at that age. You know what I'm saying? So, keep doing your thing. You know what I mean? I really don't have much else to say. They're doing it because they're either gold diggers or they've been raised to find a man that's stable, moving forward,
or they're young and that's all they're worried all about right yeah. now. Because they're not looking for a husband right now, they're looking for a good time. Yeah,
they're looking to be carted around, chauffeured around in a nice car, and for you to buy them sneakers and rings and earrings and all that crap. You know what I mean? So, I wouldn't worry about it, but just start standing the girls up. You know, or if you want to, pay no attention to them once they want to be with you, once they see your fucking card. I'd just be like, fuck you. Or, I mean, if you want.
No, don't do it. No, because I know what he's about to say.
Do some pep shit on it. Do what you got to do.
Don't do it, because he's about to tell you, go ahead and fuck
be out.
And be
you
out.
Know what I'm
don't
saying?
Do that.
You know.
Don't
and you
do
won't
that.
Be a virgin
no,
17
be bad
times over.
Karma.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't do that. That's bad karma.
And yeah, coming back on the girls. See, because they came after
don't
him.
Don't listen to him.
Yeah.
He's spiteful
you're,
and
yeah,
giving bad
you're
advice
the,
right now.
You are the deliverer of karma. You are karma man.
Please don't. Don't listen to all that.
Karma man, my disciple. Go out and deliver karma.
No, because if you start fucking them and leaving
girls.
Them, having no intention of being with them, that's gonna happen to you, so you're gonna meet a girl that you really like, and she's gonna fuck you and leave you. That's bad karma. Don't do that.
Do what I tell you to do. Hey, you make your own decision. You really do. Don't be telling people it's because you lost your virginity. You don't want no public CNN outcry. You know. Get Tyrone Maggins off the airways.
Because you know you've heard Tyrone say many a times, wait as long as you can, because girls cloud your head. So you made your decision, you've got more confidence now, that's great, but don't tell people to come to us for advice on how to lose your virginity. Go wash your
channel. I know I didn't give him that advice. What I did was I pumped him up, I gave him the motivation to take care of his grades and his life and his confidence.
And then
the girls are pulled in by the confidence. It just happens. That's how it is. So, all right, man, thanks for writing this. And, I really appreciate the letter. 1 million subscribers! Woo!